He started his career at Hindustan Copper Limited, Khetri Nagar, Rajasthan as process engineer and left HCL as senior process engineer in the year 1995 on being selected as assistant director group 1 for the Central Civil Services cadre through Union Public Service Commission for the Ministry of Small Scale Industries, Government of India. Initially posted at branch MSME Development Institute, Mangalore, and had an opportunity to serve at Mat Goa, Goa, and Hubli in the same organization. He has 33 years of experience in the field of process, metallurgy, and enterprise development, and at present heading the micro, small, and medium enterprises testing station at Bengaluru as joint director. During the last 26 years of service in the organization under the Ministry of MSME, has been trained in the area of ISO, IPR, women empowerment, supply to defense, project identification, policy formulation, export promotion and documentation, JDD certification within the country and abroad to gain the expertise and skill for the promotion of MSME sector and entrepreneurship. Sir, have a short-term training at Durham University School, Durham, United Kingdom, on empowerment of women through enterprise development by Government of India. Also had an opportunity to visit Dubai, Australia, and France. Investigation of factors in influencing exit inventions of micro and small enterprises in India. Born and brought up in.
I'm audible. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're audible.
And I have been transferred to Bangalore, and since 1 year, this is the first program after joining in Bangalore. So it is a memorable event for me. So with the blessings of Jai Sri Gurudev, I start today's session workshop on entrepreneurship and innovation as career opportunity. I must convey my regards and respects to the principal and convener Dr. Ravi Kumar and Dr. M.B. Anandaraju, and I must actually recognize Dr. Navin B., Associate Professor, Department of ECE, for bringing me to this platform. I thank you, Dr. Navin B. sir, for continuously interacting with me and make it this event happen today. So with this, I just start my session. Entrepreneurship as a career, innovation opportunity. Everyone educated are called as a professional. This education must be useful to the society by one or other way. Either this education must be helpful to get an employment or to get employees posted in your organization or to the service to the society. In three ways this education must be useful, otherwise there is no meaning of RN degrees. And this education is actually mostly used for getting an employment in these days, and very less number of educated youth wanted to become an employer. That is the irony of education system. You are all become in the verge of a professional. You are under the process of coming out as talented professionals within a few months. I just wanted to give who is can be called as a professional. I have actually many definitions who a professional is, but I most like the definition given by Dr. Subrata Bakshi, the founder of MindTree, an organization founded in Bangalore. And Dr. Bakshi is himself individual impact in somebody's life for higher education. But traditionally, the business families, the children are actually brought up under business circumstances, engagement. So at the end of the program, there is a question answer, and one girl was asked what is a bigger commitment. You are actually willing to take it up strongly, entrepreneurs. As normally, like any other discipline, it can once they achieve the excellent in that. There are many opportunities will be there, but either something will go somewhere. About very successful, then people will be writing stories about you. Some extent, more number of.
If we requested, sir, definitely, sir will give some words to our students like that. Report, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Further, we will look forward to you in your future, in future events, sir. In our college, in I am looking forward to you in offline, sir. In our college. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. We'll meet on the way to Mangalore. I'll get down one day and meet you all.
Definitely, sir, we are welcoming always.
Okay, thank you, sir. Any question, anything is that they can ask. Otherwise,
any question? No, sir, there is no
questions. Okay. We can go for a lot of time.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. Thank you very much, sir, for sparing your time for today's workshop. It was a very useful session for us about the entrepreneur. Thank you so very much, sir. Now, I request Ms. Nisha B.R. To render the vote of thanks.
And on all, I, Nisha B.R., studying third year in BE in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering in BGSIT, Bijinagara. I would like to extend gratitude to Dr. K. Socrates for accepting our invitation and sharing his knowledge with us. Thank you, sir. I thank our beloved principal and IIC president, Dr. B.K. Narendra, sir, for his encouragement in making this event happen. Thank you, sir. I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to Dr. M.B. Anandraju, professor and head department of ECE, BGSIT, Vijayanagara, who has been a pillar of support. Thank you, sir. I take this opportunity to thank Dr. Ravikumar, G.K., IIC convener, professor, R&D head, BGSIT. Thank you, sir. I cordially thank Dr. Naveen K.B., Professor, Department of ECE, BGSIT, Bijinagara, for his support. Thank you, sir. I would like to thank Dr. Naveen B. and Dr. Manoj Kumar S.B., Associate Professor, BGSIT, Bijinagara. Thank you, sir. I thank all the faculty members and students for making time and attending this workshop. Hope the knowledge gained from this workshop will lay path to many young minds attending this workshop. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Ms. Nisha. An investment in knowledge pays the best interest. With this quote, I thank one and all for your patient listening. Have a good day.
Sir, thank you, sir. Socrates, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Bye. Okay.